Welcome to the Dr. Erin Show. May you live your truth. Good morning. This is Dr. Erin, straight from Los Angeles, California, teaching universal law, spiritual truth, and having fun with the shift in La La Land. So here we go, you guys. Awakening your one thing. That's the topic. So I think that whether you are developing a business, whether you are trying to find your purpose and calling, or whether you are finding your niche within working for a company, today is all about Wealth Wednesday, right? So we talk about leadership, money, career, and things like that on Wednesday. So today the topic is awakening to your one thing. And I'll never forget when I was in ministerial program, we had so many incredible books from ancient wisdom and religions and philosophy and all this stuff. And I'll never forget we read one book that was kind of a traditional self-help book and not necessarily spiritually based. And it was called The One Thing by Gary Keller. It was a great, incredible book. So if you don't know who Gary Keller is, he started Keller Williams Real Estate, the number one real estate company in the world. And I believe the book is genius because as a spiritual practitioner, Doctor of Divinity, what we really teach is that we are here to demonstrate our consciousness in form through universal law. We basically direct energy onto our subconscious and universal law, and we set in motion a whole stream of events. So the entire concept of having one focus is really the most powerful you can be if you're directing it. If you're all over the place, then it's not going to be, you know, you're not going to have the effect that you want. And the reality is that you will always be successful. So if you have no goals and your goal is whatever, you're going to have 100% success in whatever. So you might as well pick something that you want to direct it towards. So Gary Keller goes into the concept of having one thing. What is the one thing that you could do that if you did that one thing, it would basically null and void many other things? So his one thing now was to write that book. It was the real estate company, and then he realized that to develop the real estate company to be the leader that he wanted to be, not just having the effect in the real estate industry, he wanted to really have a positive impact on many people, because as we know, like Maslow's hierarchy, we have a human desire. Our human desire is to survive, number one, then it is to connect and be able to thrive, and then it is really to get into that self-actualization period of life where you actually are making a difference in people's lives. And I believe that that book was his giving back in that realm. So the question is what is your one thing? And how do you tap into that one thing? So I would say the number one thing that people come to me for is to find their purpose and calling. And we've gone over this many, many times. And many times we are, you know, so caught up in the programming that we've had from our culture that we think that what we want is not necessarily what we truly desire. Because the truth is that you're not here to win the rat race of materialism. You're here to experience the depths of your soul and form. And I know that on this Wealth Wednesday, that true wealth comes when you fully embody and embrace your uniqueness. There, you are the only person in this entire universe that's you. And we want you. We want your expression. We want your art. We want your heart. We want your inventions. We want your genius, your specific purpose and calling. And so I know that today is really when you align to your heart's purpose and calling, you direct it into your one thing. You are free to be you. You know, there's only the brand. You know, people are building their brands and their platforms and all this stuff online. The brand is you. People want you. They want authenticity. They're dying for somebody who's not bullshitting them. You know, they want somebody who is fully being them. That's why, say, Apple, their commercials, their marketing was genius, because it was basically finding your unique expression. They had all these people with, you know, mohawks and different colors and different outfits on, because they really were embracing the individual. That's something we value in the modern culture, is our individualization, our individual nature. So that brings me to, you know, the daily universal law, which is the law of individualization, because I believe that spirit, we are really meant here to be individuals and connected to everyone. But it's like being codependent. You can't be happy and thriving if you're just enmeshed with everyone else. Somehow we have to find our individualization to thrive with everyone else, right? So the law of individualization states you are the individual of the one spirit, a unique divine expression. Universal laws are designed to be uniquely directed by each person for the specific experiential outcomes, meaning that you are the microcosm of the macrocosm. You get to use the one mind specifically. That's why each person is experiencing this life completely individually. Okay, so furthermore, you are the only person in the entire universe with your divine gift. This is you. This is like, you know, if God was to say, you know, I want to create the perfect flower, you know, you are that perfect flower. You are all of it in this unique expression. And so I know that as you stop living inauthentically and with dissonance, you will arrive more and more into your divine power. People want something unique. They're dying for something different, okay? And so on that note, I know that today's daily spiritual practice, and how do we embody this? How do we actually embody the law of individualization? So today I invite you to take 10 minutes to go into silence and set your intention for the day. And every day, set your intention. You know, as leadership programs, we set our intention for 10 years out, 5 years out, 1 year out, and then we set it into our quarter each year, and then the month, and then the week, and then the day, and then the hour, right? So that's how we focus our one thing. So every day, I invite you to take 10 minutes in the morning and set the intention. What's your one thing that you want to really produce today that you really want to focus on? And then breaking it down to the hour. Okay, this hour, I want to produce and be effective in this one thing. And the more you practice that, the more you're going to have command over your mind and direct it onto the one thing and inform universal law, okay? So then today's challenge is, because we have a game of life here, is the challenge is to let go of any project that isn't alignment with your one thing. And you could take that into all areas of your life. What relationships are no longer in alignment with your focus of your life? You know, you can still have them in your life, but they don't have to be in your life all the time. What in your diet and your nutrition is not serving your one thing? You know, is a bunch of junk food making you not have enough energy to complete the one thing that you want to complete today? And then, all the projects in your business. Are there different projects that just are hanging over you and having a weight over your shoulders, letting those things go and going, you know, I can't do all these things, and better off focusing on this one thing that I can really leave as a legacy of my life that is going to fulfill me, that I know if I completed this one thing, that I'm going to get my message and calling to the world. Maybe that one thing is being the best mom you could ever be. Maybe it's being the best partner. Maybe it's just enjoying life. That's your one thing. I don't know what that is. It doesn't have to be some big product or some, you know, big business. It can be your one thing. I don't know what that is, but guess what? You get to decide what your one thing is. And there's so much freedom in that. And when you get clear on that, it's amazing. And some people go, well, I don't know what my one thing is. How am I supposed to find that one thing? Guess what? All you need to do is follow your bliss. So what's your bliss today? What is your one thing that is a blissful thing? And, you know, maybe that's dysfunction. Maybe your one thing is doing heroin. I don't know. But go for that one thing, because I know that the breakdown is the breakthrough. Life is all designed for your awakening to the greatest version of yourself. And I know that sometimes we have to learn the hard way. Sometimes our one thing is something that is not serving us, but we just can't stop doing it. And guess what? We're supposed to learn that there's a lesson and a blessing there for whatever reason. I'm not telling you to go do drugs today, trust me, but I do know that whatever we resist persists. And sometimes people need to go down an avenue to discover their one thing. Many people that their one thing is recovery and helping in that arena, it was because they had to go down that classroom of life and discover and learn lessons so that they could be the message and the voice for that industry. So whatever your one thing is, I know that you have a specific one thing that no other person on this entire planet has. And I know that we want that. We want your one thing. We want your one gift, your one legacy to come together in this unification of this great masterpiece called life. And so on that note, you guys, you can find me across social media as Dr. Erin. It's drerin.tv. And I'd love to hear your comments. I'd love to hear what topics you want to talk about. Also, if there's something personal you're going through, you can private message me and any of my social media, or you can email me. And I'd love to hear what you're going through. Love to hear personal stories, personal questions. Because if you have that question, guess what? Many other people have the same question, I promise you. And it's a very vulnerable thing and a very courageous thing to come forth whatever problems you're going through, because whatever you're going through, I promise you, millions are going through. We are connected. We are one mind, one life, one heart. And human beingness is very, very predictable. It's actually very predictable. What's not predictable is what your one unique gift is that you're going to bring to the world. We want that. We're waiting for that great surprise and open the greatest present, which is to be present to this experience called life. So on that note, have a great day, you guys. Love you very, very much.